Three things, let's solve this volume of this cylinder with a triple integral. So we'll be using a triple integral which looks like this. 1, 2, 3 integrals. And it will be in respect to not only the r, but also the theta, of course. This will be polar coordinates with a double integral. And because it's a triple integral, we will also have dz, where dz connected to the outer one, d theta to the middle one, dr to the inner one. Now, what will the argument be? Well, first let's figure out what we're actually taking the volume of. And so we have this cylinder, and it is a simple shape. There's a circle being its base, and it has a certain height. The height is 10, from 0 to 10. This is the we can say this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. Right? X-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. So this is from 0 to 10 on the z-axis. So we can say from the most outer one, the bound will be from 0 to 10. The bound will be from 0 to 10. So we see that from 0 to 10. Now the bound for the second one will be from for the d theta, because we are taking the entire volume of it. We're not taking just the half above the x-axis or below it. We're taking 0 to 2 pi, because that's the entire circle from here, 1 pi, 2 pi, all the way here back. And then dr, because it's the entire radius that we're taking, is from 0 to 1. So from 0 to 1. And now the argument would be just 1, but because this is a cylindrical coordinate problem, we have to multiply by r. So the argument will be r. Okay? Hopefully the bounds are clear and everything so far. And now for the first step, let's just rewrite the two outer ones. Hopefully now it will be more visible. This was too small. 0 to 2 pi. And now we will integrate this at 1 and at 0. D theta dz. Now let's rewrite this. 0 to 10 and 0 to 2 pi of 1 over 2 d theta dz. And this will be equal to, and now we will integrate the middle one. So keep the outer one from 0 to 10. This is the height of z. Then 0 to 2 pi, and we're integrating in respect to theta. So we're doing 1 half theta. And now we are plugging in 2 pi and 0. Okay? So let's plug it in and then dz. And this is equal to, let me write the solution so that we only have an integral left that is in respect to dz. And so we will have just pi. We have just pi minus 0, so that's pi, and it will be in the respect to dz. So now let me integrate in respect to dz, which will be pi z. So pi z evaluated at 10 and at 0. So this is just 10 pi. So we see that the volume of the cylinder is 10 pi. And it's also logical, because if you take the volume the way that you basically use the formula for calculating the area of a circle, which is pr squared, you will get p pi times r squared, which is pi, and because r is just 1 here, and then times 10. So you have 10 pi, and the result is correctly that way. And so maybe let me write the normal formula for the calculation of the cylinder. That is just, so the volume of this is pi r squared times height. And this is, in this case, this will be just 10 pi. So it is equal to what we got through the triple integration. And of course, in this example, triple integration was not needed at all. It was really not needed. And by the way, even if we were doing a cutout, you know, if we, for example, wanted cutout that we would only be taking, you know, r from 0.5 to 1, so just half of the outer half of the radius, and now you're taking like this cylinder with a hole inside it, we could also calculate that without integrals. Because we would take the volume of the entire cylinder and then the volume of the cutout and subtract it from the cylinder's volume and get the volume of what would be left. But anyway, hopefully this was understandable.